This shows that the Biden administration is actively trying to improve our country's broken immigration system. Even while congressional leaders remain fixed in their standpoints to not do anything to address. We have some major immigration news to cover today. A transcript of a meeting between the Department of State and the American Immigration Lawyers Association was recently released, and it revealed even more information about the growing visa backlog and the steps that will be taken to address them. The Supreme Court also released a major ruling on TPS holders and their ability to adjust status and file for a green card in the U.S. In some exciting news, a 46-page document was obtained from the White House that details President Biden's steps to increase legal immigration. And finally, in an effort to get Biden's immigration policy passed in Congress, Vice President Kamala Harris met with leaders in Mexico and Guatemala to discuss the U.S.-Mexico border crisis. We're going to cover all the details right now. Make sure you stay tuned to see how this news might impact your case. Also, I spent a lot of time putting this video together, so I would appreciate if you would like this video, subscribe to my page, and help me grow my channel. Okay, so what did the Department of State say about the visa backlog? On May 27th, the Department of State hosted an outreach event with the American Immigration Lawyers Association Liaison Committee, during which they addressed a broad range of questions about the visa backlog. Notes from this meeting were recently released on the Department of State's website. Recently, we have been learning a lot about how the Department of State has been handling the visa backlog. In my previous video, I summarized this information from their monthly visa bulletin discussion, as well as the recent live stream with their visa expert, Neil Vermillion. The notes we're discussing today are from a different meeting with even more information about the backlog and how they are addressing it, so let's take a look. One of the biggest topics of discussion was the reopening of embassies and consulates around the world as we start to come out of this COVID-19 crisis. The State Department has reported that as of May 12th, 133 out of 139 immigrant visa processing posts are processing at least some routine immigrant visa services. The remainder of those are only able to do emergency services. I know that this may still not be enough information for you because you may already be waiting for your interview and you're wondering how long will it take. Keep listening. In addition, 160 of 223 non-immigrant visa processing posts are offering some routine non-immigrant visa appointments. The remaining 63 posts remain closed for all but emergency and mission critical services. When asked about the plan to reopen the remaining posts, the State Department has continued to say that the local conditions will dictate the ability for the posts to reopen as the safety and welfare of the staff and applicants is paramount. Hopefully, we do begin to see more vaccine rollouts across the globe, and we will see these posts begin to reopen and offer routine visa services. The State Department was also asked about the possibility of doing Zoom interviews instead of in-person interviews, which is a possible solution that many of you have suggested. When asked about this, the State Department has said that they do not have any plans to amend the current regulations that require interviews to take place in person. They cited current regulations for immigrant visa applicants to appear personally before a consular officer and swear to their application before that officer. They also cited statutory and regulatory requirements for biometrics collection as part of the immigrant visa application process, which requires the application to be signed in the presence and verified by a consular officer. So, as much as I would love to see all of these posts reopen and operate at full capacity and also include virtual interviews, it does not look like this will be likely as there are actual regulations and federal laws that would require in-person appointments. In addition, the Department of State has said the National Visa Center launched a pilot program to communicate with applicants who are documentarily qualified and pending an interview. Currently, there are over 500,000 applicants stuck in immigrant visa backlog, and all of them are eager to get an update on their case. If your interview has not yet been scheduled for an interview, the NVC will send an electronic notification 60 days after your case has reached documentarily qualified status. The notification assures applicants that they don't need to take any further action and that their case will be scheduled for an interview on a first-in, first-out manner as soon as local conditions permit. The message will then be repeated every 120 days until the case is scheduled. So this should certainly help those of you who have been waiting a long time for an interview and are wondering whether you should upload more documents or refresh certain certifications. Ayla and the State Department covered a lot more information than I could cover in this video, so I am including a link in the description below. Next, what was that Supreme Court ruling that made headlines all over the news this week? On Monday, the court made a ruling that immigrants who have been granted TPS are not considered to be admitted for the purposes of adjusting their status in the U.S. This means that merely having an application for TPS approved does not register into an admission into the U.S. for the purpose of permanent residency. This case involves a man named Mr. Nis Sanchez, who came to the U.S. from El Salvador in the late 90s. He had entered the country illegally and had later received temporary protected status. After living in the U.S. for years and building a life here, he wanted to apply for a green card. However, his application was denied because underneath current immigration law, in order to pursue permanent residency, you must have an admission into this country, which is interpreted as a legal entry into the U.S. Mr. Sanchez's argument was that the grant of his TPS constituted a legal admission into the U.S. and thus that he could make his application for permanent residency on this basis. The Supreme Court, however, ruled that meeting the requirements for TPS is not sufficient to override the language of the current statute, which outlines the process for becoming a permanent resident. Their decision stated that whether or not they agree that TPS should override the need for a legal entry, they are bound by the law as it is written. So what does this mean? If we want to grant TPS holders who are here without a lawful entry a path to permanent residency, we are going to need to pass comprehensive immigration reform in order to help them out. Until we reform the language of the laws, we cannot change the current state of our immigration. I will include a link in the description below to the Supreme Court's decision. In some good news, the New York Times obtained a draft of the Biden team's plans to significantly expand the immigration system. The 46-page document called DHS Plan to Restore Trust in Our Legal Immigration System details numerous initiatives intended to dismantle former President Trump's restrictive policies, as well as reduce the visa backlogs affecting hundreds of thousands of immigrants. The document is essentially a blueprint for how to accomplish the immigration policy President Biden campaigned upon. Proposed changes outlined in this document include making it easier for more people to immigrate to the United States, including highly skilled workers, asylum seekers, and farm workers, reducing fees or providing fee waivers for immigrants who file their applications online, increasing virtual interviews and electronic filing, revamping the U visa program, which provides non-immigrant visas to certain crime victims who assist law enforcement, implementing new regulations to encourage full participation by immigrants in our civic life, expand immigration opportunities for LGBTQ refugees from countries where they are persecuted or where same-sex marriages are not permitted. While White House officials declined to comment directly on the documents, they have said that documents go through many drafts and that decisions about specific steps to address legal immigration remain in flux. So, unfortunately, none of these changes are happening at this time, so this is merely a draft, but one should certainly hope. This shows that the Biden administration is actively trying to improve our country's broken immigration system, even while congressional leaders remain fixed in their standpoints to not do anything to address. This is something that we will be watching closely, and I will bring you more news as soon as it's available, so make sure you stay tuned. Finally, why did Vice President Harris visit Mexico and Guatemala, and what does it mean to immigrants in the U.S. Kamala Harris recently returned from a trip to Guatemala and Mexico, where she went to talk with local leaders about the current state of immigration at the U.S. border. This is her first trip since being tasked by President Biden to address the immigration situation at the border. This news is important because Republicans in Congress have done whatever they can to avoid passing or voting on President Biden's immigration reform plans. If you recall from a previous video that I did, even those bills with bipartisan support, like the DREAM and Promise Act, are unable to move through Congress because of the border crisis. So on this trip, Vice President Harris focused her efforts on the issue of illegal border crossings. She highlighted that the root causes of these crossings include government corruption, drugs, human smuggling, and political instability in these countries. As a part of these efforts, the Biden administration has committed nearly $300 billion to help alleviate poverty and crime in the region, particularly in El Salvador, Honduras, and Guatemala. This includes an investment of $48 million in entrepreneurship programs, including affordable housing and agricultural businesses in Guatemala. And while she spoke about the efforts being made to address the cause of migration at the border, what got the most attention was the clear message she had for those thinking of making the trip north.
I want to be clear to folks in this region who are thinking about making that dangerous trek to the United States-Mexico border. Do not come. The United States will continue to enforce our laws and secure our border. There are legal methods by which migration can and should occur. But we, as one of our priorities, will discourage illegal migration.
In case you missed it, in my last video, I summarized comments from the Bureau of Consular Affairs about visa movement in the coming years, as well as what they are doing to address the visa backlog. This is probably the most important thing to understand about visas if you or someone you know are waiting on their employment or family-based application. I will continue releasing more information as it becomes available, so make sure you stay tuned, subscribe to my channel, and turn on notifications so you don't miss a thing. Check out this video, and I'll see you there.